Hello, and welcome to About Anything. Welcome Back, Kotter was an American TV show that ran on the ABC network from 1975 to 1979. Over four seasons, the show produced 95 episodes. The show followed a high school teacher in charge of teaching remedial education to his students, and it features a foursome known as the Sweat Hogs. In this video, we'll explore the top 10 moments and trademark elements of this under-the-radar classic. Starting us off at number 10, of course, is the theme song. Written and recorded by John Sebastian, the song Welcome Back reached number 1 on the charts in May of 1976 when a full-length version was released. The song is played at the beginning and the end of all episodes. This is the opening theme and credits during season 1.
Welcome back. Your dreams were your ticket out. Welcome back to that same old place that you laughed about. Well, the names have all changed since you hung around, but those dreams have remained and they've turned around. Who'd have thought they'd need ya?
Who'd have thought they'd need ya?
On the spot, welcome back.
Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back.
With number 9, there is a cast change. With John Travolta missing time with his movie making, the show introduced a new sweat hog to be named Bo. In this scene, the remaining three sweat hogs have their first meeting with Bo.
The principal's office is right over there, Bo.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm new here and somewhat dependent upon the kindness of strangers. Thank you for this, too. 555-2161. You just stay by your phone tonight, here?
You remember my number, too, won't you, Bo?
Oh, darling, there are three things Bo Delabar never forgets. Names, phone numbers, and how to hang up if your daddy answers. Excuse me. Hi, my name is Bo Delabar from New Orleans. I'm new here. I wonder if you might direct me to the nearest principal's office.
Well, hush my puppies. I tell you what you got to do, darling. What you got to do is you go around old Magnolia Bush, down Tobacco Road, then up your plantation.
But us poor white trash, we just take the third door on the left.
And land sakes now, child, land sakes. You make sure your mammy know where you is. She gonna be worried about you.
I'm sure you gentlemen wouldn't mind if this young lady showed me the way.
Not if you wouldn't mind getting a boll weevil shoved up your nose.
Listen, fellas, I'm not looking for any trouble. I'm just looking for the principal's office. Or anything else I might find along the way.
Well, fiddly-dee, Massa Juan. The South done rose again.
Get off my back. That new Southern dude's just a mouth.
Yeah, it's too bad his mouth is gonna be all over Doris's lips.
How would you like your lips all over your face?
I wouldn't like that at all.
Well, I didn't think so.
Well, you're very psychic.
Now, Gabe. At number 8. There was the guest star role for George Carlin. Carlin would appear in a second season episode in which Freddie became an instant success on the radio. But his success also made him lose his friends.
Listening to the big sounds of the meter readers and their brand new disco hit, Baby, Stick My Head in Your Oven.
Oh, I can't believe it. It's Wally the Wow in person.
And the hits keep rolling on. Here's one from the Reverend Funk and the Vienna Boys Boogie Band entitled I Threw My Heart in the Collection Plate. You got it, because you asked for it. Well, 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 here they are. The Sweathearts, class of 78.
Where?
In your case, make that class of 85.
Wally, on behalf of all the guys, we want to let you know that you're the greatest.
Okay, take it easy on the shirt, man. It's an oldie, but it's a goodie, you know?
It's an oldie, but it's a goodie. Oh, he is so hip, so very, very hip.
Why don't you guys have a seat? We got a few minutes here before we have to start.
For number 7, in one of the more funnier episodes, we get a look at Epstein's art project, or as he calls it, Epstein's Madonna. In this scene, Juan reveals it to Kotter and the rest of the gang. But wait, I wonder who was the inspiration for his artwork.
May I present to you Epstein's Madonna.
All right.
That's very nice.
It's the first time I've seen an artist sign his name up somebody's nose.
Well, it's a good thing she ain't alive. One big sneeze and you'd be anonymous.
It's all right, though. I like it. Hey, you guys ain't seen nothing yet. The rest of us around the corner.
Really? Well, look, Ron, why did you paint her around the corner?
It's a heck of a lot easier than straightening out the wall.
Oh, boy.
Kotter, this is an outrage. She's nude.
I'm an artist. I paint what's inside of me.
The problem's not what you've got on the inside, it's what she's got on the outside.
Now I know why my sister has her own room.
Epstein, she's supposed to have clothes on.
I ran out of paint.
Yes.
Now listen, Epstein, either you put those grapes where they do some good, or I'll send you to Principal Lazarus's office.
Hey, right, come on.
Wait a second. Mr. Woodman, that's not for you to decide. I mean, this mural is his art class project.
It's wonderful. And what's he doing for social studies? Invading Poland?
Take it easy, huh?
Juan, Woodman does have a point. I mean, the lady's nude.
Come on, I know my rights.
This is a schoolyard wall. A lot of people go by here every day. Now, if you wanted to paint something like this, you could have done it on a canvas.
Look, you don't understand. It's art. Now, that's my vision of life, and I ain't gonna change it.
That's right.
That's right.
So listen,
he's got a right.
Besides, once I connect the dots, that's that.
With number 6, we find ourselves introduced to Freddie Boom Boom Washington. In this clip from the pilot, which oddly was episode 3, go figure, we get an early appearance of his greeting, hi there, as well as the explanation of the Boom Boom nickname.
You kind of butter me goo. Hi there. Washington, Freddie. Boom boom.
What's the boom boom for?
Boom boom boom.
I get it. Boom, boom, you play the bass. Boom, boom,
boom. No, man, I just like to be doing this.
At number 5 is Juan Epstein's notes. As you can see in this clip, Juan had an excuse ready for all occasions, and he famously signed them as Epstein's mother.
A great gang. Great.
Epstein, what are you complaining about? You don't have to get initiated.
Yeah, that's because I got a note here. You gotta see this one, man.
Dear Punk, please excuse Juan from his gang initiation because of an inner ear problem. He hates to hear himself scream. Signed, Epstein's mother.
Number four. In the show, the act of putting someone down or insulting them was known as ranking them. This show played heavily on this element. In this classic scene, Kotter squares off against Vinny in a competition.
Barbarino, if your study group would write a report on censorship, the effect on the male teenager.
Yeah, well, Barbarino don't write no reports for no one.
Barbarino don't write no reports. What does Barbarino do besides give orders?
Hey, Vinny's the ranking champ of Brooklyn. Take a bow, Vinny! Hey!
You mean insulting, chopping, sounding?
The dozens.
The dozens. Okay, Barbarino, let's see how much talent you got.
You're asking for it, Kotter.
You're right, I'm asking for it.
Up your nose with a rubber hose.
Washington, go to the blackboard, write that down under 1975. Another one, Barbarino.
I heard you had an idea once, but it died of loneliness.
Come on, Barbarino. That the best you can do?
Hey, off my case, toilet face. I'm doing terrific.
Okay, now, Washington, go to the other side of the board. Write down 1965. Hey, Barbarino, I understand your sister's rotten to the core, but wonderful to the infantry. And they tell me your father got a new job last week. He became a skin diver for Roto-Rooter. And the word's out that your mother...
Hey, not my mother.
Your aunt.
Not my mother.
Your aunt is so low, she plays handball against a curb.
Not my mother. That woman is completely holy.
Okay. Thank you, Washington. Now, I think we have some clues here to how our society has changed in the last 10 years. This is very interesting. Notice, 1975, the attack is direct upon me. I am described as a toilet face whose one idea has died of loneliness, and who, if Mr. Barbarino had his way, would be walking around with a rubber hose sticking out of his nose. However, in 1965, it's different. The attack is not upon me, but upon my family, my sister, who is described as Mr. Woodman.
Moving to number three, the role of Mr. Kotter was played by Gabe Kaplan. Kaplan, at the time, was a stand-up comedian, so there was an element of the beginning of each episode in which Gabe would tell a joke, mostly to his wife, Julie. Here are a couple of those jokes.
Did I ever tell you about my uncle who was a paratrooper?
No. Why don't you tell me about him?
Okay, well, his name was Sky Kotter. He decided to become a paratrooper. Wanted to jump out of planes. So he goes to this school, and the instructor takes him up in a plane, right? And he says, okay, when we jump out of the plane, your chute's going to open automatically. Now, if it doesn't open automatically, you pull your emergency cord. Now, if your emergency cord doesn't open the chute, you pull your super emergency cord, and that'll open it. And then when you get to the ground, there'll be a truck, pick you up, and take you back to the school. Okay? Jumps out of the plane, chute doesn't open. Pulls his emergency cord, still doesn't open. Pulls his super emergency cord, it still doesn't open. Passes the instructor on the way down. He said, you know, with my luck, I bet the truck won't be there either.
Julie, did I ever tell you about my Uncle Malcolm, the traveling salesman?
No, why don't you?
One time, Uncle Malcolm is in Duluth. Checks out of his hotel, he goes to the train, and he noticed he left his umbrella in the hotel room.
Well, what did he do?
Well, he went back to the hotel, went up to the clerk, he said, I'm Malcolm Kotter, the traveling salesman, and I have left my umbrella in room 923.
Okay. What did the clerk say?
The clerk said, Mr. Kotter, we just rented that room to a honeymoon couple. Now, if you want to go up there and knock on the door, that's up to you.
Well, what did Uncle Malcolm do?
Well, Uncle Malcolm goes up to the hotel room, and he's about to knock on the door when he hears from inside the room, whose little eyes are these?
Why, they're yours.
Well, whose little nose is this?
Why, it's yours. Well, whose little neck is this? Why, it's yours.
And Uncle Malcolm knocks on the door and he says, listen, when you get to the little umbrella, it's mine.
At number two is Horshack's noises, for lack of a better term. He had two famous noises. The first was when he was excited to answer a question and would proudly raise his hand. Second is the famous Horshack laugh. Both can be seen here.
Impressive, Mr. Kotter.
Hello. How are you? I'm Al Horshack.
Horshack, you have returned. Our life had lost all meaning without our little friend, Horshack, to lend a helping hand.
Here, Benny! Here's my helping hand!
Mustache. Mr. Woodman.
The number one moment or trademark element of Welcome Back, Kotter was the Barbarino song. Sung to the tune of Barbaran by the Beach Boys, Vinny lets us know what his last name is. Here is two clips of this awesome song.
Right. Now loosen up. We gotta loosen up here, right? All right. Start to relax.
Start to feel who you are. I say the ba 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 Barbarino, ba 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 Barbarino, ba 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 Barbarino. Got a rockin' little wheel and then a boppin' and a wheel, boppin' with me.
Earth Company, come in, Vinny. Here is that Sicilian songbird, the wonderful Mr. Vinny Barbarino.
I said a Barbarino.
So there you have it, our top 10 moments and trademark elements of the TV show Welcome Back, Kotter. How did you find our list? What would you have added? So until our next video, please like and subscribe. This is About Anything.